Awesome. Okay.
Good. Good, good, good. Okay. So I watched your replays. At least most of them. Yeah. And we can definitely talk about quite a lot. So would you rather jump into TVC or TVT first?
Let's start TVC.
TVC, okay. Good. Then let's do TVC. Oh yeah, notes. Notes, notes, notes. And TVT. Okay, okay, okay. Good. So I saw that you play some kind of Heart of the Swarm style in TVC instead of the 2-1-1.
Yeah, yes, something.
Yeah.
As I said yesterday, I literally have no build or plan whatsoever. I just make units.
Okay. I thought that just holds strong for TVT, but if it's for TVC as well, okay. We can fix this today, potentially.
I'm a bit more comfortable in TVC and TVP, but like TVT.
Mhm. Yeah.
In TVT is worse.
Yeah, I saw that your macro is kind of slippery. You have basically, as you said, no real plan of what to do and why and when. So, but we can get this. Okay, let's fast forward a little bit here. You go Rex, Gas, Reaper, standard stuff. So that's totally fine. Yeah, there's the Reaper. I assume normally that doesn't happen to you, that all the SCVs follow one SCV instead of mining.
Oh yeah,
Okay. I was wondering why are your minerals so low?
Me too.
Oh no, it's still happening. Oh wow, that's...
Yeah.
Oh my god.
No, it took me a while until I realized.
Ouch!
I was thinking, why do I have only 10?
Yeah, it's so weird.
I mean, I was looking at the CC, but I was not seeing them.
I see. Oh, that's...
First game or something.
That's not good. Okay, so it explains a lot. There, wow. Okay, it explains a lot. Like, but it's okay. So of course your build is not that crisp now, but you still, you can be fine. It shouldn't happen, but you can be fine. Let's just see what's going on here. So yeah, one Reaper, starport behind. Okay, normally. Just a small thing to start with.
Yep.
I would get the starport next to your factory and barracks, because you will do a lot of switcheroony stuff. Mm-hmm. Lots of switching is going on between those buildings, like on the tech lab, and then it's more near. So, and also your base lines up nicely, so you have a better base layout basically if you have all the production in one line, like five production facilities in the line, then a small gap, and then you continue. That's nice for defense, etc. It's not a big deal here, but it's okay. Your mules are not really constant as it looks like, so you are busy microing your Reaper currently, and that means your mule is late. You're just now saturating the gas, the second one. Now you're busy microing against the circlings, which means your stimpack is a bit... Oh no, you get Benji. My bad, sorry, you get Benji. Okay, never mind. The switching is a little bit late then. And okay, so here's the thing. You get four Hellions and one Reaper, and the Reaper is still alive here, which is super, super risky. He went for Speedlings, yeah. So speed normally, speedlings finish at 3 minutes 30. So that means that you should pull back your Reaper at 3 minutes 20. roughly, so that the Reaper survives. Either the Reaper gets back, or it confirms that there is a third base, and currently you don't know if there is a third base. And interestingly, the third base goes up at 3:30 as well for Zerg. So that means if you don't scout a third base up until the 4-minute mark, you should be very, very curious about a two base, like Nidus or Spire, like Mutalisks. And that's what you need to check with the Reaper. If the Reaper dies, then confirming, it's okay. If you can keep the Reaper alive, even better, but just don't waste it. So better pull it back at 3:30, like if there is no Overlord, maybe to the Watchtower, or maybe here in this case. Just so that you can scout, is there a base coming up? Yes, no. And if not, then you can jump into the natural, see what's going on there. If you don't see anything there, the Reaper dies, throw a scan in the main base. You need to check if it's Mutalisk or Nidus, or maybe just a huge Ling Flood or a Ling Bane attack. You need to know what's coming. So basically, at, I would say, 4 minute, if no, third base, go scout with Reaper and scan if needed. And what you do now with your Hellions, that's okay, but your barracks doesn't need to produce a reactor. You see, your factory isn't producing stuff, so you can just switch those. And the barracks can immediately begin producing marines for your bunker. So instead of the reactor, you could have had two marines out right now, already. Okay, and the purpose of the Hellions is normally not to kill anything. Like, if you get Zerglings, that's good. But all the Zerglings and the Reaper want to do is deny creep. Maybe trade some Zerglings, but this move here is very risky already. If you would have had more Zerglings, he could flank you and come from more sides, surround your Hellions, and they all die. And you need those Hellions. If you play the hot style, then you go 4 Hellions or 6 Hellions, sometimes even 8 Hellions and 1 or 2 Reaper, it depends a little bit. Then those Hellions, they can get into the mineral line sometimes. And if you kill 10 drones, awesome. But most of the time you want to keep them alive. They are just there to deny the creep spread for Zerglings. Trade a little bit against Zerglings, but not overcommitting. Don't lose the Hellions, because with the hot style, you want to hit a very strong 2-2 mid-game timing. And if you have 8 Hellbats later on, then those Hellions will be Hellbats. With your push, that is so much more firepower. Especially nowadays, where most Zerg just go pure Ling Bane. Like, a massive amount of Lings. 70, 80, 100, like, wow! And Hellbats are so good against them. So you don't want to waste those Hellions. And you get some Zerglings, that's nice, but I think they die now very... Yeah, that was,
yeah, well, was
a little bit slippery. Dead. Yes, that's sad.
I think for that as well.
Okay, so your command center comes down now. Oh yeah, if you play your style, which I refer to hot style, normally you get the command center before the double barracks. Because with that opening, you want to be super greedy. Basically, your command center should get up at the same time as the hatchery, which is like at 3:30.
Right.
Maybe minute 4. But yes, stuff like so. Basically, it is really close to the normal timing of the Zerg hatchery. And what that means is you play super greedy, so you need to confirm what's going on with your Hellions and the Reaper, and you can throw a scan. If he goes for an all-in and you lose 10 SCVs, you're still fine. Even if you lose, depending on what all-in he's playing, you can even lose 20 SCVs, and you would be even because of the triple command center and he goes all-in. So it is okay if you need to pull SCVs, if it's a roach attack and he busts the bunker and you need to wall off with SCVs, do it. It's totally fine. But you need to check what's coming. Interestingly, you go only for one Banshee, and if you go only one Banshee,
yeah.
I would skip Cloak, and instead get a Viking next. So you get a Banshee, then you switch the starport with the barracks, so the barracks can produce steam. The starport goes maybe on the reactor, and you can get normally it doesn't go to the reactor. Normally the starport just lifts, stays naked, and gets a Viking. And with the factory, then you produce lots of reactor for the barracks to get then the reactor instantaneously. So after your first Benji, basically, what you want to do is get Stim, naked starport for a Viking after that reactor, and the factory constantly produces reactor for your barracks, which you are building. Mm-hmm. And as well, you want to wall off. Yeah, you got a wall off, you got a bunker, that's fine. When do you get the double eBay? I think it is like at 4:30, something like that. So your racks come really late in this style, like 4:30 to 5 minutes, I would say, and between 5 minutes and 5:30, double racks, and after that again two racks. So that you are on 5 total. And when your third is, yeah, it, you will see it if you play more the style, if your third is like halfway saturated, I would say. Then you add 3 more racks. Or instead you can add, that's another style, you can add 2 factories and 1 to 2 starports. And what you want to do with that is go widow mines, lots of widow mines, mass mine style. And it works, especially in diamond, up until master, it works really well if you go a mass style, mine style. Because what it's
mass link style.
Yeah. Against roaches? No, never. I will get this. Only versus Ling Bane, not versus Roach Ravager. That's very important. Mines are very bad against Roach Ravager. Versus Roach Ravager, you need tanks, tanky vex. But yeah, with what the mines do for you, that's the fun part. Basically, Zerg forces you to micro against the Banes. Split, pick up, stuff like that. But with the mines, Zerg needs to micro, and you can just sit there, pre-split your army, stim a couple of marines, or maybe marauder later on, which is even better. Oh yeah, you will have 5 racks with reactor, and 3 with tech lab, if you go 8 racks. So that you can go marauder as well. Marauder are really good for tanking, they have the concussive shells. Yeah, right. And you can chip away Baneling. So if he comes in, you kite back with the Marauder. Marauder also are really good for clearing creep, because creep is, I think, armored. Yes. And they do bonus damage against armored types units, so creep will get cleared earlier. Faster, I mean. So, yeah, Marauder are really good against Ling Bane as well. Not overmake them, but if you have, like, 3 Marines, and for every 3 Marine, 1 Marauder, That's basically the ratio you wanna have, I would say. Maybe 4-1, 3-1, something in between that is really good. But with the mass mine style, you just get the 3 factories, you get drilling claw upgrade, pre-split, and the Zerg doesn't know what to do, basically. If he doesn't have the sickest splits and baits, he will have a really hard time, especially if he skips mutalisks. Then it's getting even worse for him, because he can't, with Mutalis he could snipe the mines. But if he skips them, which many Zerg nowadays do, they just go pure Ling Bane into Corruptor, into Ultralisk. Yeah. Maybe some go for Infestor, but Infestor are not really good against mines either. So, And mines are really awesome. I just had a game 2-3 weeks ago, and in the end of the game I never went for ghosts. It was late game against Ultralisk, but I won, and in the end I had 34 mines with the speed drilling claws. I felt so bad for the poor Zerg, but I won. He had no chance. And you don't need that much bio then, because the splash is so good, and the mines are also awesome against Corruptor. they tend to clump up when they want to focus Liberator. You have the money for the Liberator because you go so many mines. Just don't waste your mines. If you fight and the fight is over, pull back at least, if you have 12 mines left, pull back 10 of them. Let 2 there for maybe lucky hits if you forget about them, but pull most of them back. Even though they are cheap, you don't want to waste them. Okay, then let's see what we can do as well. Yeah, your e-bays are a bit late. You get double tackler, which is fine. You don't necessarily need to do that, but it's okay. Yeah, you are not muling at all. I don't know how we can fix this the best. You need to start muling constantly. Up until you are fully saturated on 3 bays, you want to have most of the times mules instead of scans. So sometimes you're forced to scan. If you push out, you want to clear creep, of course scan instead of mule. But as you can see, you have 3 mules currently available on your both orbital commands, and you want a mule. You need the even though you are heavily over, you have lots of minerals in your bank, but that is because of your opening and the lack of production facilities to this point. Yeah, right. So, and maybe you wasn't constantly producing as well, not hitting all the timings. So normally you will be short on minerals, really short. The timings are very, very crisp to hit. So those 1k overmints should never happen. Never, never, ever. So, and now it's just macro, macro, macro. And you, yeah, now you go SCVs. Basically, all your production facilities want to produce all the time. Like, never, never stop producing. Never, ever. So, you wanna go up to 66 or 72 SCVs. Okay. And now there's the double drop coming out of you, and that's cute.
Yeah,
it's not a bad idea. If you, how is this overlord spread? Okay, this guy is not a very good example of how good a Viking would be.
Yeah, because he only has like about 2 overlords.
Yeah, he has like 2 overlords on the map, which is not much. Normally a Zerg has like 8 on the map, or maybe 12 even. And if you then get a Viking, as long as he doesn't go 2 base mutalist, the Viking after the Banshee is always worth it, like always. If the Viking kills 3 overlords, massive. You kill 3 overlords, which means he has to remake them, which means 3 larva is missing, and he's missing the vision out of them. Awesome. Really awesome. Potentially you could even supply cap him, which is really good against a Zerg. So let's see, there's the double drop. Okay. Very good spot here to drop, as well as here. He doesn't see either of them. Sadly, back at home, you lose a lot of SCVs there. Those circlings, because you didn't really react there. Look at that. Those 8 circlings, they wreck your entire mineral line. And that really hurts. If you wouldn't have taken that damage, you would have been totally fine. Because you are dealing quite some damage as well on his side of the map. But sadly you lose all the marines. It would have been nice if you would have saved those. So always, the thing is, the multitasking is very hard. That's the problem here. So before you start to do those drops were good. They dealt a lot of damage, don't get me wrong. But I think back at home you didn't really produce too much in the meantime. So if you instead focus on your macro, getting the rexes up, spend your minerals, don't lose 10 SCVs, but still, to the circlings, then you would be in an even better spot.
Okay.
I really do think with macro you could come get the furthest. Those drops are important, and they are necessary, don't get me wrong here. Against, as a Terran player, you need to be the aggressor most of the time. You need to be out of the map, on the map, deal constant pressure. Otherwise, Zerg and Protoss will just run away with their economy from you. Even with perfect macro, and mules, it's still very tough to win against those. If you let them do what they want. So sometimes I would say go for the drops, yes, but don't
neglect production.
Yeah, right. So go in, see if you can find damage. If not, go turn around. It's and focus more on your macro. You're also just on 5 racks instead of 8 now. And the fun part is, normally with good macro, with really good macro, and I think that's your main issue currently, with good macro you could be maxed out at like 9 minutes between 9:30 would be GM level, I guess, but for you it would be nice at 10 minutes as well. And even if you trade, you can hit this timing, so you can be maxed out. Even if you do trade like 20 SCVs and a medevac, you can be maxed out at 10 minutes. And you are 115 supply currently, so you are missing 85, which is quite a lot. Just imagine you would be maxed out now against this Zerg. And he would have, maybe even if he would have 50 supply more, you would be still 50 supply ahead. Mm-hmm. And that's really a lot. A lot. So with that would be really good. Just give me a second. Okay. I still think here. What you do nice, you get a lot of medivacs, and so far you didn't lose any of them, which is really awesome. You want to keep those alive as much as you can, and you do a really good job so far. So that is really good. Do you often get supply capped in your games?
I drop a lot of
okay.
Supplies.
Okay. Because there is a trick you could try out, which basically is that you
leave the idle SCVs.
Yes. So you say you need at the start you have one SCV with two bases full saturated, basically then two SCVs, and you don't send them back, you just, as soon as they idle, build additional supply depots with them. That's the idle worker trick, and so you will never ever be supply kit again. I would give it a try. It's really helpful. Oh yeah, that really does hurt. Oh yeah, and also if he busts through your wall, rebuild it. Don't let it be open like that. Always rebuild your wall. In TVC. In TVP nowadays with the adapts as well. So the sad thing is you lost so many SCVs in this process.
Didn't even realize there were so many.
Oopsie. What are your control groups? What do you use for what, basically?
Just 1, 2, 3 for army, 4 for production, and E-base and CCs that go on the, basically on 0.
Okay. On 0. Okay. How do you press 0? Do you have a mouse?
No, it's Q.
Q. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I was just wondering because your +2 armor was so is still not being researched. I mean, now you don't have the money, but you had the money times and over again. So
yeah, I tried, but then I forgot. I tried when I didn't have the money, but then I forgot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, I was just asking because if, as you said, you have it at the same control group, and that means that you always will see if the upgrades are still running or not every time you produce an SCV. You know, if they are in the same control group, you see it basically all the time, so you have an automatic check.
Don't pay attention.
Okay.
As you don't even look at the production. Mm-hmm. I just
okay.
And pay attention to them.
I would start looking. Do you see? Yeah, I would start looking down. Because then you also see that if you can mule or not. Mm-hmm. And I think that would greatly increase your macro potential there. If you look down, every 12 seconds you click on your hotkey Q for your command centers, produce SCV, and just a short look if you can throw down mules. And then you also should see if the upgrades are still running. So if you get used to that, you should never miss me, or most of the time, miss your upgrades or the mules, and then you have more money and can get sooner to the 8 racks, 1 factory, 1 starport, or 2 factories, or 3 factories if you, and 5 racks if you play the Mass Widowmine style. It should greatly help here. Okay. Oh, that's sad. It's really funny how you still are really in this game and potentially win this. I don't know, actually.
I didn't realize. I thought I was way more behind than I really was.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Yeah, your splits seem not that strong currently, so I think the Mass Widowmine style would really be helpful for you. So you basically, in TVC, never step on creep, pre-split your army, and with the mines you will do this automatically, because you need to split your army against mines, or with mines as well. Mines need to be splitted, you know, to be really effective. And that means you will split your mines, and then you automatically should also split your bio with this as well. So you have a pre-split before in front of the creep spread, and then you can use your marauder, stim in, clear some creep if he comes, pull back, and slowly but surely push forward. And at some point he has to commit, and if he runs into 12 or even 20 mines later on, it will be really hard if you have bio to back it up, so he can't run behind your army to do the friendly fire. He will just suffer really hard. The problem is you're trading with 2-1 upgrades against 3-3 now. That's the problem here. Yeah, I do think macro is your biggest potential to improve and get into higher leagues very soon. As you can see, you are still on 5 racks production instead of 8, and you have only 1 factory instead of 2. So with better production you would have had more army, and then you just need a little bit of pre-splitting against the banelings, and I think then you would be fine. The drops were okay, but instead the macro, I think, is what you really need to focus on. Mm-hmm. So let's go into a TVT, I would say. Yeah. That was a good one. Okay. So So then let's see. Okay. You're blue, you're down there. Good, good, good. Okay, so do you go... Okay, you don't go gas first. That is okay.
This conversation last night with somebody.
Mm-hmm. But if you don't go gas first, even if you do, but I saw you don't scout at all. Like,
sometimes send an SCV.
You need in TVT. You need to send an SCV. You have to, and I would say you send the SCV. Let's see, right? This SCV now producing, being produced in the command center. That's the SCV you want to send out. So if your barracks is like 10 seconds in the game being produced, this SCV needs to be sent out, basically. With that SCV, you should be able to get into the main base of your opponent before he closes it with a supply depot. And you can check, was it gas first or not? Does he go 3 racks? Is it a proxy? And you need to know this. If you don't scout at all and you go Marines instead of Reaper, which is... It is okay, you can play Marines, it is possible, but you need to scout. Reaper are still more viable, I would say, early game. With the 2 Reaper and the 1 Hellion, it's just better normally. But you can go into Marines, but you need to scout. A 3 Rex Reaper would totally kill you, for instance. The problem is also, the problem is also that you have 2 Marines now. There is 1 Reaper out, and he goes, I think 3 Rex Reaper, I don't know, he's playing something, or maybe 2 Rex Reaper. And you don't know what's coming up, so it can be game ending already very soon. It is really dangerous to not scout in TVT nowadays. And 2 Marines are, the problem is Marines, they don't heal themselves like Reaper do. So he can always come in, trade a little bit, and go out, heal up, and come in again. And if you would have had better micro, this game could end right now. But he does some major mistakes. But he's dealing quite some damage as well. The interesting part is, if you now look on the SCV count, he dealt so much damage to you. Like, no, it wasn't so much. Wow, only 3 SCVs. I thought he would kill way more. Okay, never mind then. Never mind. That was strange. I really thought he would have killed way more stuff there. Oh yeah. Do you have any build order for TVT, or are you just freestyling?
No, I don't think even freestyling it is. He's being generous.
Okay. So let's see if I can find a build order which, I mean, you really don't wanna open up with Reaper, right?
I could.
Okay.
Defensively, yeah. I mean, I don't mind using 120 produce.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, you can. Okay, if you then let me see. Maybe what, how do you feel about Banji, Cloak Banji?
I haven't tried in a long time. I think the TVZ earlier is the only time I went in the last month.
Mm-hmm.
Cloak Banji. I used to go a lot at the beginning of HOTS, just to counter Ravagers and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I meant in TVT. Do you feel confident using Banji, Cloak Banji in TVT? Yeah, okay, awesome. Then I sent you... On that web page, you basically find a lot of build order which you can try out, spawningtool.com.
Mm-hmm.
There's also a VOD. It is a bit old, and maybe the build is a little bit outdated, but I would still say it's viable. and you open up with Reaper, you get the scouting, the Benji. I just yesterday had someone who played Benji, and after my coaching he went for some feedback and he wrote, yeah, now with after the coaching, the Benji always wins him the game in TVT already, which was really nice to read. So it is still viable, and he was also Diamond, so it's totally viable in your league. Up to GM, definitely you can play Club Benji, I would say. So in TVT, let's do some basic stuff here, because about the build, if it's freestyle, I can't really tell you much. But in general, in basically all matchups, you wanna have some kind of vision or map control. Do you use the all army hotkey a lot?
It's not bound.
Sometimes okay. No, if it's not bound, that's already good, I would say. You definitely need it sometimes in some games. Even professional player use it sometimes. But if you don't use it so far for all the time, that's good, because then you can have SCV Marines right here for the watchtowers. And you always in TVP and TVT, as well as TVC, you want to have the watchtower. And then also maybe park one Marine here, and one Marine here, and one Marine here. Just to know, it's five Marines, it is a commitment, but you see a lot. You will know, when is he taking his third base? When is he pushing out? Are there drops coming? You basically see everything. And you will have 20 to 30 seconds time, depending on the map, to react. Or even catch it. Just imagine he goes for a big Doom drop, and you spot it with the watchtower right here. This gives you more than enough time to set a huge trap. I mean, you could elevator down if the rocks are not broken, which you always should do in TVT because of the tank evacs. If he positions behind those rocks and they are not broken down, you have a lot of problem, I would say. Even if they are broken down, it's still difficult to push down the ramp, but it gives you more options. Because then you could come from behind, down the ramp and elevate or something there, do a nice flanking move. Let's get shortly rid of all the pings okay. So now let's you have the vision and a 4 medevac doom drop with 3 tanks and a lot of Marines comes your way, and you see it right here, and you see it. Not only of the minimap, you do realize, oh wow, there's a big drop coming. And you would just get down 20 Marines with some medevacs here and wait for him. And you wait, you saw it's coming, and you stim there and kill all the medevacs. That's like 40 supply. Just because you had one Marine spotting it, you were able to kill 40 supply. Not even macro could do this for you. But vision. So vision is very important. Always have vision on the watchtowers, potential drop pathways and push out pathways, and next bases your opponent wants to take, like a third or a fourth or a fifth, so that you know, okay, what's coming here and when. And then you can prepare, react. That's really helpful. In TVT, yeah, here's again the thing with the mules. I don't know. I need to see. Oh yeah, there are your supply drops. Ooh. The problem with the supply drops is, sure, if you need them, do it. But really try out the idle worker trick, because every supply depot with a supply drop on it is 300 minerals worth. It is super expensive. Really sad that you lose this fight. And yes, because you are not constantly producing SCVs, let's see. When was the last time you produced SCVs here? Oh wow. Okay, there we go. So how long was it in this case? You are very far behind in SCVs, Although I think your command center was earlier than his. Yeah, so now you stop at 8 minutes.
I lost a lot about the time.
And now you go. So like you, those are 4 SCVs you are missing now. And this is happening over and over again in your playstyle. Over and over again. So you are missing 2 SCVs, then 4 SCVs, then maybe 3 SCVs, and it adds up a lot. So yeah, with the looking down, I think you should be able to fix this. Also, your armory and your second eBay are a bit too early. When you're... Okay. And now you see with the rocks why this on this map this is so problematic. I mean, this push out he's doing, basically, you could do as well. Way earlier, and it can win you lots of games, and especially on that map in TVT. But to get back to the eBay and the armory, if when your 1-1 is halfway done, so if you have double eBay for instance, and you fire up 1 armor and 1 weapon upgrade at the same time, then if it's halfway done, you want to add the armory, so you can instantaneously fire up 2-2 when 1-1 is finished. And the say if you have only 1 eBay, then you start the second eBay and the armory when plus 1 armor upgrade is halfway done. So always when it's halfway done, and then it lines up perfectly for you to be able to get 2-2 instantaneously behind. Yeah, and that's game. He just really out-macroed you, and he dealt some damage SCV-wise. I mean, you lost 37 SCVs in this entire game. Most of them were now in this push, but still. That's now... I do think with a clear build and some focus on macro, you will be way better in basically every matchup. Mm-hmm. Not only TVT or TVC, but in every matchup. So if you get your timing straight, have a clear build order. The nice thing is with the website I just showed you, there are so many builds you can go through them and see. Some of them have even videos where they show how it's played, and then you can see, is this nice? Is it fun for me? And then you can just see for TVT, TVC, and TVP what's the best build. In your league, you don't need many builds. You can get Master, even GM, with only having 1 build on ladder. As long as you're not cheesing all the time, it's totally fine to just go for a good macro build and play this straight down. And how is that? Hit the timings, like 7 minute, 100 supply, 9 minute, 930, max out.
Okay, I can work towards that.
Sorry, again?
No, I can do that.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Basically what I did when I switched to Terran.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Just did the filter thing.
Okay. 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 I haven't seen how you... No, let's see that game. Let's jump back to TVC here and see how are you doing here. Just to check if all the macro issues are the same here as well, and if you might find something else we can talk about to improve. But basically so far I see macro, definitely macro. Okay, barracks, refinery, everything's good. This time you have enough money for the command center. Oh, you go a marine. Okay, if you... interesting. Don't you play... do you play freestyle TVC as well?
No, yes. No, I don't actually go for... I think the Banshee thing was like a one-off thing. I usually just go with the Hellions and...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because
maybe a third.
with your current opening, I feel like the gas is
Yeah, it's too much.
It's a bit too early. Yeah, you could skip it and get the command center earlier. It's good that you scout with the SCV, and his third base is super fast. Like, that is so greedy. It's super greedy. If you
I don't think I realized at the time.
Yeah. I just think about if you could try to punish it, but it's difficult. Maybe get a bunker next to it, reactor, and pump out up to 6 Reaper. With Marines it's very difficult, because on that map you don't get up to the bunker then. So you would need the Reaper to jump up right here in order to pressure it. And it could work out, but for you I would say just stick with your macro, and maybe go with the hot style. I don't think there is a build order for this on that website in TVC. It's quite outdated.
That's fine. I'm totally open to new things. I don't.
Hellion Banji, Stimpak, Factory Command Center, Double eBay. Yeah, you could try out that one, for instance. It's roughly the same, which I said, just a little bit different. But with the notes I give you later after the session, you can tailor that build towards whatever you like. But the idea is basically the same. So he goes for a tank push. Instead, you can go just for a marine push, or you don't push at all and just wait it out until you got to 2 for a big push. However you like. So it's totally up to you. Yeah. Will you hit 100 supply at the 7-minute mark? I don't think so. The barracks are not producing for quite some time as well. Okay, so you can see that there is, if you don't trade at all, you could be on 110 supply on 7 minutes as well. And as you can see, you need this macro to get better, because this Zerg, for instance, has a lot of supply already. And you are quite far behind. Just imagine you would be on 100 supply now. He has 8 roaches and 5 queens. And if you would have 26 or even 36 marines more, for instance, now, you could just move across the map, kill him, stim to win, that's it, bam. You wouldn't need any focus fire. You have a good 1-1 timing then as well. 1-1 will finish up in roughly 20 seconds. So if you would push out right now across the map with 100 to 110 supply, you would crush him. You would hit a 1-1 timing, even have a window of 10 seconds where his 1-1 is not finished, so you will deal even more damage. You would just crush him completely. You would have no chance. Instant win. At the 8-minute mark, you would at least, I mean, bam, GG. So what I would recommend for you now is, even though it is quite boring, but just to get used to better macro, go into custom games and try to hit the timings, like 7-minute 100 to 110 supply with looking down and muling and the upgrades, and 9:30 to minute 10 for you being maxed out. And if you get this 3 or 4 times in a row without being badly supply capped or anything, do the idle worker trick, then go back to ladder and just try still to focus on it. And you will see how many units you have, and you should win most of the games. Of course, eventually you will hit another border, I say, where you will be on 50-50, because that's how the system of Blizzard works. They want you to be matched 50-50 win-loss. But for the first few games, you should drastically increase your win-loss ratio if you get way better macro. Look at your production tab. look at it. You're microing your heart out and banking a lot of minerals. The Zerg as well, but he is Larva. He can just press some keys and bam, all the money is gone. And he has like instantaneously, not as fast as Protoss. His injects are not so good as well, but for Zerg it is okay to bank up like 600 to 800 minerals as well for Protoss. For Terran, that's a disaster. You need constant production.
I see.
And yeah, your upgrades, your 2-2, that's the sad part. If you would look down there, and the timing was there to, I guess, instantaneously have 2-2 upgrades. You also have some idle SCVs, which you could use for supply depots. Yeah, your 2-2 would be way better, way earlier here as well. I think he will just out macro you in this game, sadly.
Mm-hmm. No.
Yeah, he goes up to Hive Tag. And the sad part is, if you don't have good macro, you don't have units which you can use, which you need to use to pressure your opponent. So if you have more units, that's always good to have. Even if some all-in is coming, if you have good macro, then you don't need that good micro at some point. For some instances, maybe not in Diamond, but maybe in Diamond still even. The times that the your opponent might hit with an all-in are not that crisp. So even if you don't really scout it perfectly, you just might have to have enough units to defend it either way. And then what it does for you is, even though you didn't pressure at all or do anything special, you just did macro and you will get ahead because he traded poorly and didn't macro as good as you, and then you're ahead by basically doing nothing. This fight was surprisingly close.
Yeah, but in the end,
to see the difference here again, let's see the fight. The supply before the fight, because after the fight you were quite you traded quite good, so you could be maxed out basically, you could, and this fight was close already. Just imagine, you would have 50 supply more, you would have crushed him, push across the map and win, because this fight was so super close and you took it quite okay. I mean, it was not the worst fight I've seen so far. There are 3 Hydroliths and those Corruptor left. And I imagine 50 Marines still there to fight against that. Even the 12 Hydroliths he now made and the Roaches. Even without Medivacs, it would crush him completely. Stim to win. So this drop is nice. You kill a Hatchery and totally force him back. Sadly, you lose those units. So also always try to save your units. If you drop, unless you can with a drop of Marines totally kill an entire mineral line, better then don't commit too hard and just pull back and save those. Like you drop, for instance, you drop right here, always outside of creep if possible, drop here, stim in, maybe kill the queen or 3 drones and at the gas geyser. And then when his army comes, lift, pull back, drop here, heal up, and 10 seconds later you go in again. And you do this 2 or 3 times, and then you switch it up the position, because then he will be prepared. He will throw down spines or park 8 roaches there, then you won't find any damage. But then you can drop maybe here, or maybe drop here. Yeah, just switch it up a little bit. And if you don't lose those units, later on you can... You have 2 choices then. You can use them for your big push to join your army to reinforce, or you can do a multi-prong attack with them still. So if he splits up his army to defend your drops, then you gather all your army and do a big push, because then he's split. And if he doesn't split up and has a big army, then you split up and force him to split up to defend the drops. That's how Terran basically works in every matchup.
I see, alright.
Nice. So this is also over already, this game. No, I think you have a lot of potential. You just need to work on it. And if you get this, you should see massive improvement very soon.
Okay, no, I'm just lost because it's not like I'm looking for promotion or anything. I know I can do better. I was a bit better only a few months ago.
Yeah.
But even then, I mean, by when Legacy came out, I think I played a lot more. I played a lot more.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I mean, first season, my goal was to reach like top 5%. And I almost did it.
Wow. Okay.
The second season, when masters were 6%, mm-hmm. I couldn't play, and I was so fuck.
Ah no. I see. Yeah. Are there any questions you have left for me before we close this session today?
Actually, there were some, but I think I've. So no, I think I wanted to ask about gas price and DVD, but to be honest, I.
No. Oh, okay.
No.
If you go gas first, basically you want to have the factory as soon as possible. Otherwise, you won't go gas first. So if you go gas first, the factory comes down right after the barracks, even before the Reaper, because you want to hit the starport, or if it's Cyclone against in TVP, for example, you want to hit that as soon as possible. So if you don't go for a factory after you go gas first, then don't go gas first at all.
Okay. I think one more question. I think in PvD I managed to find a Protoss yesterday,
mm-hmm.
but it's just like late.
Okay.
I guess I'm not still that used to losing to just mass gateway.
Yeah.
So again, in the end, I'm guessing you just better macro, but. I really, really need liberators for it.
At least.
He opened blinked. He opened blinked first time.
Yeah, blink is good against liberator, but you can. Yeah, I would say you need liberator. At least widow mines. But basically, if he doesn't go colossus, you wanna have a lot of liberator and bio, as well as either widow mines or tanky vags. While tanky vags are more expensive. They are really useful to have. At least two or three of them are okay, but normally I would go Liberator, Mine, Bio. You need Liberator. If it's not Phoenix or Colossus, then they've definitely you need Liberator. If it's Phoenix, Colossus, double Starport Viking, I would say.
Alright. Okay.
Yeah, awesome.
So that opened my eyes a bit.
Yeah. Okay. Awesome.
Yeah.
Then I will. You're welcome. Okay. I will send you the notes I made. Hope I covered most of it at least. And then it's time to watch the Casper Cup. Woo! Maru playing.
Yes.
Okay. So. Okay.
Thank you again.
You're welcome. I wish you best of luck. Have a good one. See you.
Likewise. Bye.
Okay. Bye bye. Heyo there. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye bye.